Welcome to the Prayer for Patience. This is simply a prayer I've put together where I'd like to pray for anyone within the sound of my voice. All I ask you to do is to agree with me as I pray, and together we will seek our Heavenly Father. Please continue to meditate on this prayer for yourself, speak it daily, or listen to this over and over again, and allow the Word of God to reach deep into your spirit. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we gather together and come into agreement in the wonderful and powerful name of Jesus. Where two or more are gathered, there you'll be in the midst of us, and anything we agree upon as touching, you will surely do. The Bible says if there's any unforgiveness, that it should be dealt with before praying. Therefore, we release any anger, bad feelings, resentment, or any other wrong attitude before you now. We lay it at your feet, and we release and forgive those who have wronged us. Father, in Jesus' name, there's no distance in the Spirit, and we thank you for the listener who desires a prayer for patience. Oftentimes we can feel like we've held on to your promises, Lord, for what seems to be like an eternity with little or no result. Why can it feel like our patience runs out before the answer comes? Oh Lord, the listener admits that they are in a fight, and it seems that waiting patiently has become difficult for them, hence the reason we're here praying. We ask you for help in developing patience for the listener. They look to you and depend on you, Father. They trust in you to take care of them. They surrender their life and desires to you. By your grace, they surrender, Father, their entire life before you. They relinquish control to you now. We declare that the fruit of the Spirit abounds in the listener's life, Father. That's love, that's joy, that's peace, that's patience, kindness, goodness, gentleness, and the ability, Father, to keep their body under control, self-control. Father, the listener belongs to Jesus, and they believe that the Holy Spirit is leading them in every part of their life. Father, they need your grace and strength to stay in what they are facing right now until it is finished. They need patience. Yes, Father, their desire is to be persistent and committed to keep up the good fight of faith until they can see the fight is finished and victory is accomplished through Jesus. Father, your word says that promises in the listener's life will come about through faith and patience. That's what it says in Hebrews. And Father, your word also says that patience, as we just mentioned, is a fruit of the Spirit, but that also patience can come from scriptures, as it says in Romans 15:4. So Holy Spirit, we ask you to fill the listener with a fresh supply of your power and your strength and resolve, your supernatural level of commitment, so that they can establish the habit of reading God's word more and drawing patience out of the scriptures. Help them to dive into the word and to fill up on patience. Now, Lord, we understand that as they do this, Father, that you will bring about that growth of patience within them, that you're going to do the work. If they'll step out by faith and get into the word, Father, you will have patience rise up from within them. They may not know how, but Father, you know how, and by faith they trust, and that they will step out and do what you instruct. We decree and declare that they will stay in the fight till their assignment is fulfilled because they abound with faith, faith in your word, faith in what you say, but also patience. Now, some have said that patience, Father, can be described as faith over a prolonged period of time. So we declare that the listener stands in faith until they see the answer to what they seek. We believe that you know exactly what the listener is facing, and praise your name that they're not fighting this good fight of faith by themselves. They're not alone. No, the Holy Spirit lives in them and is filling them fresh and new right now with his power to hold fast against any opponent that would try and stop the listener from seeing the answer to their desire. Father, today they yield. The listener yields to the Holy Spirit and allows him to fill them to the brim with his power, so that they can stay in this fight of faith until it's over and they've won the victory. Hallelujah. When trials and temptations crowd into their life, they'll resist them, Father. They will not give in to them. They realize that they have these trials, these tests, Father, these temptations have come to test their faith and their trust in you, Father. But they will not draw back in fear. The listener will stand strong in you, knowing that you empower them from within through patience. Lord, we ask in Jesus' name that you give the listener a complete knowledge of your will with all spiritual wisdom and understanding, that they will, Father, always honor and please you with their life because they have this wisdom and understanding. In turn, Father, they will get to know you better and better, and as they spend time with you and your word, they will be empowered so that they will have all the endurance and patience that they need, Father, and faith to see your promises come to pass in their life. Praise you, Lord. with patience. They are able to withstand difficult times of anxiety, Father, worry. They're able to overcome and defeat all of that and fear. They overcome by the blood of the Lamb and the word of their testimony. If there's anything or anyone, Father, that they need to remove from their life, Father, that might be hindering their walk with you, show them, Lord. They only look to Jesus, the one who began their faith and makes it perfect. Glory to you. Father, thank you that you're going before the listener and working with them. You will not fail them, and you'll never leave them. You'll never forsake them. In the name of Jesus, Father, the listener will resist cowardice and fear, refusing to become broken in spirit, depressed or dismayed or unnerved, Father, with any sort of alarm or fear. In Jesus' name, by the power of the Holy Spirit, we declare that they will throw those things that hinder them and the sin that so easily entangles them, all those weights, Father, they'll throw it to the side so that they can run the race you've set before them with patience. Hallelujah. They fix their eyes now on Jesus, the author and perfecter of their faith. On the authority of your word, Father, we decree and we declare that the listener is like a tree planted by the waters, Father, that will prosper no matter what circumstances come across their path, Father. They will not be anxious. They will not care, Father. They will not be fearful, but they will stand strong in you, Father, just abounding in patience until the promises come to pass in their life. We are convinced, Father, and sure of this very thing, that you who began a good work in the listener, even during this prayer, you will continue until the day of Jesus Christ. Yes, Father, you will develop and bring it to full completion. Thank you, Father, for creating in the listener. Father, I mean, even the fruit of the Spirit, Father, there's patience. They've got patience because they've got the Spirit inside of them, Father. And the fruit of that is patience, Lord. And we thank you that you've put patience, Father, amongst the Scriptures. So as they spend time with you and your Word, they're drawing even more patience, Father, from the Scriptures. And so we thank you for that, Father, that you're creating in the listener a steadfast, patient spirit. We declare that the listener is patient in Jesus' name. We believe and receive everything we've prayed. We give you glory in advance for this prayer, and we believe it's answered. In the wonderful and precious name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.